talked to them since they did Rancho Santa Fe. I haven't talked to them. I golfed with them out there a couple times or once anyway. And my son lives in Sherman Oaks, not too far down the road from us. So I need the chance. They're getting older now, They're sweet.
They really are. Isn't that weird? Small. Alright, I'm ready.
Good morning, everybody. Come on in. Hey, who's the winner? What is it?
About 3.5 million users worldwide. right here. This is Lumber. So this is your home page. Right here is where you'll be able to see your different prayer lists, your different journals. And so you'll notice recently my mother-in-law moved into my house and noticed I have a meeting plan titled 7 Days of Forgiveness. I don't know. And so Janet, if my mother-in-law does this, is this way to just know how lucky I am. But right here, we like to say, you just grab your coffee and sit down at the homepage. We're going to take you further in the Bible than you thought possible. Is there anyone who does not have coffee? I'll come pray for you. But right here is where we really want to develop the power of others. This is the go box. So this is where your power of others lies. And you can type in any topic or any passage and you click go. So the topic would be baptism, Holy Spirit. You can break my mic up just a tiny bit. Baptism, Holy Spirit. So right here, let's say I wanted to study on or preach on the woman at the well, which we all know is John 4. So watch this as I would type John 4, and I would click go. Now, when the screen changed, what just happened is Logos just did about 50 to 60 hours worth of Bible study and message prep for me. Let me explain the layout over here. Right up here, this is my Bible translation. You can just tell Logos what your favorite translation is, and then underneath that's my commentary. Well, watch as I start to scroll, the commentary just keeps right along with me. And then one of our pastors at Logos is to assist you in the word studies. We want you in the original Greek and Hebrew. So look here in verse 24, it says, God is spirit. And those who worship him must worship in spirit and truth. So you might read that word, what does that mean? What does that mean to worship in truth? So I love it when I click on the word truth, just like that, Logos is doing all of my Greek word lookups for me. We'll give you my English definition. It is so cool, my friend. My friend is so cool. So it is doing all of the beginning my English definition, but look. In the original Greek, the primary meaning of that word truth means hiding nothing. It's basically that Jesus is saying, for those who want to worship me, I'm looking for those who worship me in complete transparency. That doesn't have to change completely how we're trying to see that. And not only that, but we spent 7 years pronouncing all of the Greek and all of the Hebrew. So you can come right here and click on this.
Amen.
So now you know how that original word is pronounced. And anyone who passed on stage or back up to God saying, oh, I was reading about God's love for us. It's just so amazing. God's a big love. It's so ambiguous. I love it. But you can say agape. It's not like that scholar we know who you are. And then over here, these are my commentaries. So this is the Bible studies part. This is my message prep section. So look, if I need a different commentary, I just click on it. And then eventually you will find something you want to share in a message. How great would it be to put God's word back on social media again? So let's say you want to fill that, whatever the case. So watch this. I'm going to come right here. Let's say I wanted to highlight this. I'm going to copy that. I'm going to come over to a Word document, and I'm going to paste that in. I'm not going to be seeing out there why I love logos, whether I'm writing or whatever I'm doing. When I scroll to the bottom, they will always cite my references for me. You can clap. It's okay. I get it. We're going to use this center, and you're going to say the innovation just on that right there. Now, let's fly through this because of time. I've got my cross-references. I'm coming along. Systematic theology, this is huge. For those who've all had systematic theologies, why I love Logos, let's say I wanted to study Christology, the study of Christ. I'm going to click on Christology, but it's going to take John 4 to my systematic theology, but by its denominational nuance. Now I'm understanding how our different denominations interpreting John 4. Because as pastors, as leaders, we have people coming to our churches from all different backgrounds. So this helps me understand how my brothers and sisters in Christ have interpreted that text over the years. Now, the United Guidelines. How many people, pastors in the room, or you have pastors, leaders, prepping messages? Many times you have to come up with a quick message. Whether it's a dedication, when you're meeting someone, whatever the case, this is an amazing part. Not only can you add your messages into Logos and they become part of your library, but right here, let's say I need to prepare a quick message. Thematic outline shows John chapter 4, and you'll see right here, let's say I wanted to do a quick message on baptism in the Gospels, which is a theme from John 4. I'm going to open that up, and when I click copy right here, it's going to be able to actually create a whole new with all of these bullet points laid out. These are the main bullet points from that sermon that I'm going to start to build on, edit, and have everything ready to go. It's phenomenal. Now, also, illustrations. When I'm preaching messages in the past, I always try to find a story related to what I'm preaching or teaching on. And how many of us know Google is not the best place to go to find those resources? I don't know if you know that, but I really would not recommend it. And YouTube logos can be what I call workflows. Many people, when they open the Bible, they go, where do I start? Where do I begin? Or even pastors, they go, man, I'm trying to figure out the flow of how I'm going to do things. We have guides that are predetermined as to whether you want to do a basic Bible study or have a workflow created for you. We also have an expository sermon workflow where we will help you get the most out of Scripture and draw the most wisdom out of that. Now, you all see how much time we're saving? We want you to have your time with God, but for Logos is saving is the biggest time saver. It's like the TSA pre-check of Bible study. Now, one last thing I want to show is called our interactives. We started to bring the Bible to life in a visual manner. So you'll see right here, we have a ton of different interactives, but I only have time to show you a few. This one, this is our media. So this is what we mentioned, you get 30,000 images to be able to use with no copyright infringements. One right here, this is called Miracles of the Bible. So here are all the miracles they have, but watch this. This is one of my favorite interactives. I can click on location and see where did the miracles take place. Or I can actually sort by patient, who is the person who received the miracle? Or click on agent, who is the person who performed the miracle? There's my main man, Jesus, still ranking number one miracle performer in Scripture. Or I can actually sort by text and see, you know what, I want to see all of the miracles that had to do with healing. I'm going to click healing and had to do with the person who performed it was Paul. So now, while I didn't take any time to pull up before, now I have everything I need to do my message prep. Do my Bible study right there. One right here, this was called Before and After. We've done it from places all over, and this is Jerusalem. If you went to Jerusalem today, put a drone in the air, that's what you would see. Although if you're not going to Jerusalem, you're not going to drone in the air. I did not say that. So right here, you'll see if I'm going to just grab this bar and scroll it, our best way to render what it looked like at the time of Christ. Isn't that amazing? I don't know if you know, but Bible study in America is a huge decline for two reasons. Number one, especially with the younger generation, they say the Bible is boring. We know it's not boring. It's just that things have changed with the way that people learn. This is a media-rich culture, so we at Logos are bringing scriptures to life in a visual manner. And then number two reason, they say they don't have time, and we know we can solve that. Last one I'm going to show is called Weights and Measurements. I love it. How many of you come across the Bible and read about a drachma, a shekel, a talent, whatever the case, you come across those. We wonder, what does that mean? So I'll put it right here. Let's say I wanted to type in 100 cubits. The Bible talks about 100 cubits. Now let's see, what does that look like? So there we go. It's 48.3 meters, about 4 city buses. For the lesson, next time you go to the ocean, you'll see 3.5 humpback whales, just remember. 100 cubits right there. Or, let's say you want to see, well, how much is 10 talents? Because the talent was not a skill set. Those are measured as a currency. Well, 10 talents in today's currency is approximately $12 million. And you'll look at, wow, I never knew that. So just imagine what happens when you start to make things love us more and more. Now, everyone say 4 p.m. I will be here until 4 p.m. today. And we are offering a discount here at the conference. And so at 4 p.m., it will expire. Come and see me before. I'm going to show 3 great packages, but there are some below and beyond. Come see me on the road. The first one is a basic Bible study library. So this is where you're going to get some basic translations, some commentaries. The value of this library is approximately $6,700. Now, with the third book value, that's not what you're paying, that's the value of what you're getting. So with the books and the software, it's $629, but with the discount, it's $535. Now, that is not a subscription, that is out the door. And if you wonder, well, I don't have $500 just to drop on Bible software, just let us know, we'll put it into a monthly payment plan. No credit checks, no nothing, we just put it on the plan for you. So $31 today, and you don't have the software. And then, you also get a 30-day trial. So you can test it out, play around with it as much as you want. If for any reason you don't like it, you just let us know and we'll fund that back to you. And the next one is silver. Now, for those who saw me do a word study, where you saw the Greek and the Hebrew, this is where you start to get those resources in silver. Now, all the other maps and everything you see is going to be included in all these. So This is not like we all have an eternal cell phone plan that we pay for the rest of our lives as the world's our children. So this is your software. And the last is gold. This is for anyone who's having that, you know, kind of urge or feel the pressure of the Lord to step out in ministry, maybe in a Bible study, whatever the case. This is for who start adding in imaging and teaching resources. So that's the value of the library, regular price, conference price, and then a monthly 66 to 24 months. And we also have a pastor's library. If you are a pastor, I highly recommend you need the Diamond Library. Not only for the preaching, the teaching, the exegetical, but also the biblical counseling resources that come in. And wherever I go, I've got my mobile device with me with all of my books, all of my resources with me. Now, lastly, this is an individual license. Of course, you can't buy one and share it across the board. It's an individual license, but husbands and wives, you can buy one because God says you are one, and you'll mess with that, so you're good there. And then also, you can unlimited downloads. You can put on a Mac, PC, iPhone, and Android, and whatever you do on one device, we'll see if you make it with all the rest. And then lastly here, I think if you have the old version, come see me because you basically get two discounters on the order. And then lastly, lifetime license, 30-day trial, and training. We'll teach you. We'll show you how to use this. And then lastly, I'll close with my quote by John Owen. It says, if the word does not dwell with power in us, it will not have the power from us. That's the heartbeat, the passion behind all of us. For all this. Thank you so much. And right now, the name, wait, hold that flat right now. When you get back to the flat, so here we go. The reason that most of you are sitting in church is to see about the